everything in sequence. It's all about correction, as Trevor would say. That's the way Trev is, and I wouldn't have him any other way.
Keeping the bowling greens alive in Broken Hill requires a certain dedication.
To me, he's just like a brother because he's so passionate and I love it. The whole club loves him. He's greens, he loves his greens, he loves his work, and that's Trev.
Trevor's work is hard to miss. He's a stargazer with a passion for Saturn. For more than 3,000 nights, he's trained his homemade telescope on the planet's North Pole. And his achievements are astronomical.
Trevor, congratulations. You are the 2023 winner of the Walter H. Haas Observer's Award.
Ah, Tim, I'm overcome. It's not often I'm stumped for words, Tim. That just shocked me. Like, it moved me. This is an award from my peers, you know, from my international peers. It's one of the most prestigious international awards that an amateur can receive. And I thought, have they made a mistake?
He eats, sleeps and drinks it. He's full on. He does nothing but the astronomy. And Saturn is his passion.
Well, I'm a pedantic bastard because it's so difficult to eke out the small scale detail. I've designed what I have now specifically optimised to do very high resolution imaging of the planets, specifically Saturn.
His dedication and precision led to another award last year from the Astronomical Society of Australia.
Every 2 years, they award the Berenice and Arthur Page Medal to an amateur. Well, they saw fit to award that to Trev, the Broken Hill ex-mine worker. Who would have thought? Who would have thought that even possible?
Straight from school, Trevor began an apprenticeship in the mines. But after 30 years, the company changed hands and the new owners sacked most of the workforce.
So I took the redundancy package and I thought, well, what am I going to do?
Despite being in his 50s, Trevor wanted to improve his stargazing qualifications.
How would I go, being as I had no tertiary education, pulling on a postgraduate degree in astronomy? I didn't even know if they'd accept my enrolment. 2 years later, I graduated with straight high distinctions.
It was astronomer Fred Watson who encouraged his ambitions.
You also belong in NASA because of the work that you've done for them. When the Cassini mission was operational, just scouting out those storms so that they could focus the telescope on board Cassini in the right direction.
And whether it's helping NASA or contributing to yet another scientific journal, it all happens inside a chilly backyard observatory made from water tanks.
Oh, look at that. That is corker.
And some of the recognition has been close to home. Like the family next door.
I think it's amazing.
When we heard about his most recent award, Audrey said we should do something for him.
I want to make him feel good about his award.
Trevor has settled into a comfortable routine. By night, Saturn has his undivided attention. By day, it's the greens at the bolo.
Without Trevor and Cheryl, I don't know where we'd be, I'll be honest with you, because they run it. I'm only the president. Without them, we wouldn't be having this place. But, well, I think the doors would be shut.
I'm treasurer and secretary and most of the cleaning and most of everything else.
We live out here. We should have our beds out here because we spend more time out here than what we do at home.
And as for her husband, Cheryl believes in keeping him grounded.
He's got brains to burn when he uses them.
Oh, look at that. Oh, my collimation, I reckon, is perfect.
I'm a pretty ordinary person. Like, here I am, homemade telescope, homemade observatory. Like, I just love what I do.
What a great story.
Yeah.
Gorgeous bloke.
Why don't we make a bloke like him Australian of the Year?
Yeah, that's unbelievable.
Put your nomination in now, Pricey.
Yep, I will.